Welcome, my dear friends. Myself is Professor Dr. Rajendra Deshpande. I welcome you all. Today's topic is Rasadhatu. So, myself, Professor Dr. Rajendra Deshpande, would like to welcome you all in this video session of Rasadhatu. Here you can see Rasadhatu. I think I can make a big screen and scroll it down, so that it will be useful for everybody. Okay, I feel it is more better. So here you can see the title, Sharira Kriya Paper 2 Part A. This is regarding the BMS. First year BMS students, they have this particular Rasadhatu is concept in the part, Paper 2 Part A. Part A is always Ayurvedic and Part B is always allopathic. Okay, so we will go slowly further. So this is presented by myself, Professor Dr. R.R. Deshpande. These are the books that I have written. This is the Kriya Sharira New Syllables Paper 2 book, which includes the Part A and Part B. Shantanu Prakashan is the publication. Okay, so I will try to make some different things for you. Okay, so this is myself, Professor Dr. Deshpande. I am MD in Ayurvedic Medicine and MD in Ayurvedic Physiology. And this is my mobile number 9226810630. So these are the textbooks that I have written. And this is the best book that I can see for I have written for you. This is the Sharira Kriya Vijnan Handbook. This is in Hindi and English. Allopathic part is in English and Ayurvedic part is in Hindi. So the students of the BMS course, they must buy this book. You can mail me and I can send you the PDF of this particular book. This is in Hindi and English. So it includes the rapid revision, fast revision for paper 1, paper 2, practicals, instruments, histology, everything is there. Important shlokas, all basics of dosh, dhatu and man. Okay. So this is practical book. So I will just check it out whether I can have some another facility to show you some, but cursor is okay. So this is a Sharira Kriya practical book as per the new syllables by CCIM 2012. And it includes all the Ayurvedic practicals, like for example, Prakruti Parikshan, Ayurvedic Constitution, Sarata, Agni, modern hematological practicals, cardiovascular system, nervous system examination. By the by, let me tell you, my YouTube channel has a huge database of more than 500 plus videos over there. Some are audios, some are videos, but I have tried to cover each and every subject of the BMS course, starting from the Sharira Kriya Sharira, that is Ayurvedic Physiology. Then I have the Padarth Vidyana. Then I have the Anatomy, Rachana Sharira, Dravya Guna Vidyana, Nidan, everything you will find on my YouTube channel. Please search for the, what you can say, the playlist, okay? This is clinical examination book. This is also a very fantastic book written by Professor Deshpande, that is myself. Systemic examination of 8 system. Digestive system, respiratory system, nervous system, cardiovascular system. Modern view, I am trying to say, don't need to go for any Hutchison or any other modern big books which are very difficult to understand. Okay. Then Ayurvedic Srotasa Parikshan is also included over here in this book. So modern part is there. Ayurvedic part is there, and most important, clinical significance of laboratory test. Why we do the hemoglobin? Why we do the RA factor test? Why we do the malarial parasitic test? Huh? Why we do the LFT, liver function test? What is lipid profile? Each and everything is mentioned over there. Then some, what you can say, the display of the radiology, ultrasonography, 2D echo. So you will get in this book. Of course, this is English. My books are available, Kriya Sharira books, in Marathi, in Hindi language, and also in English language, published by Saukhamba Publication, Delhi. So you can go on Amazon and search for my books, okay? So English translations are available. There are different work that I do. This is YouTube channel, then slideshare.com, www. You please note this point, slideshare. Here you will get a lot of 150 plus PPTs prepared by Professor Deshpande, that is myself, and uploaded for you people. So you can download easily all these PPT on these slide share. Okay, then I have the mixcloud.com where only audios, each and every lecture that I took to my BMS students that are uploaded on the mixcloud.com. So don't forget to visit this particular site. Okay, I will go further. These are the blogs that I am writing. Now we will start our topic, Rasadhatu. So this is not a wastage of time. You have understood what the material, study material from where you can got. Now, when we talk about Rasa Dhatu, basically the word is Dhatu. Okay, Dhru Dharayati is the original word, which maintain our human body from birth to death. Dhatus of Ayurvedic concept can be compared with tissues. Modern physiology, modern science, they explain the tissues. Connective tissue is there, osseous tissue is there, nervous tissue is there. Similarly, in Ayurveda, there are 7 tissues. Rasa, Rakta, Mounds, Med, Asthi, Majja, Shukra. These are the 7 dhatus or 7 tissues in the body. Our human body is composed of dosha, dhatu, mala. What is the principle? What is the principle? Dosha, dhatu, mala, mulatvam, hi shariram. If you want to learn Ayurveda, my kind request, this is educational PPTs. These are not the marketing videos. These are not IT, iTech videos like how to charge the mobile, how to do the PPT. No, no, this is educational videos. So I request all my viewers to see these videos. It may be long. Half an hour, 45 minutes, 1 hour, 1.5 hour. Please keep the patience and see from first minute to last minute, you will earn a lot of knowledge and also in a simple language. This is now on the screen. I know this is a Marathi script. Some Sanskrit shlokas are there, but I'm explaining you in English. So concentrate on your eyes. Try to learn some words if possible for you. If you are Marathi medium, fantastic. But still, if you are Hindi speaker or English speaking person, then you can understand my language. I am talking about dhatu concept of Ayurveda. Here is the word rasa dhatu. This is the first dhatu. Rasa, rakta, mounds, med, asthi, majja and shukra. How the human body is composed of? Dosha, dhatu, mala, mulatvam, hi shariram. This is the Ayurvedic principle. Ayurvedic principles are eternal. What is meant by eternal? Principles were there in the past, they are there in the present, and they will be there in the future. And because of these principles, Ayurvedic science is called as eternal science. Sanskrit word is Shashvat Shastra Ahe. This is eternal. Why eternal? Based on the principles. Now the practical things will be different, but the principles will remain the same. So Ayurveda says, human body is composed of 3 important substances. Dosha, Dhatu and Mala. Dosha, bioenergies. Please write it down. Dhatu, body tissues. Mala, waste products. These are like the roots of the tree, big tree, because on the roots, genesis is dependent, nutrition is dependent, stability is dependent, and if roots get decay, D-E-C-A-Y, decay, destroyed, then whole tree will be collapsed. So, utpatti, sthiti and laya, creation, maintenance and destruction, 3 words, utpatti, sthiti, laya, creation, maintenance, destruction is depend on 3 body elements, dosh, dhatu and mala. What is the Ayurvedic aims and objects? What is the purpose of Ayurveda? Swasthasya swastharakshanam aturasya vikara prashamanam cha. Swasthasya swastharakshanam. To maintain the healthy condition. So prevention of any disease, maintenance of health is the first purpose. Second is a curative and rehabilitation. Okay. So For the prevention purpose, who is swastha? Sushruta has said, samadoshaha samagnishya samadhatu malakriyaha. Prasanna, atma, indriya, manaha, swastha iti avidyate. So healthy condition is depend on homeostasis, balanced of dosha, balance of dhatu, and balance of mala. Homeostasis in all these energies, tissues, and waste product should be qualitatively, quantitatively, functionally balanced, normal condition, physiological condition. Then that is healthy person. How the disease is created? I am talking about, Dr. Deshpande is talking about importance of dhatu concept. Importance of dhatu concept. Importance of dhatu concept in prevention. Importance of dhatu concept in disease condition. How the disease is formed? Dosha, dushya, sammurchana, janito, vyadihi. Vitiated bioenergies. If my vata is disturbed, it try to find out where is the weak tissue. Where is the weak tissue? W-E-A-K. Where is the debility is there? Weakness is there. In which tissue weakness is there? That is in Ayurveda, the word is sarata. Sarata means the tissue quality examination. So whichever the weak part is there, the prakupita dosha, disturbed doshas, bioenergies, they attack. For example, is my vata dosha, because of the hectic lifestyle, is disturbed. And my rasa dhatu is not of good quality. So what will happen? My vata will attack on rasa dhatu and I will start dhaka, 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 palpitation, rudra drava. The patient will start rudra drava complaint when vitiated vata dosha attacks on the weak, weak immunity of rasa dhatu. Try to understand, immunity is depend on quality of each dhatu. There is a rasa dhatu weakness, rakta dhatu weakness, hemoglobin is low, muscles are weak, your body weight is low, your bones are weak, osteoporosis is there. So when my vata dosha will prakupita, vitiated, if rasa dhatu is weak, I will start palpitation. If my rakta dhatu is weak, I will get hypertension. If my muscles are weak, mausa dhatu, I will get a muscle cramp. If my bones are weak, I will start osteoarthritis. If my majja dhatu is weak, my memory loss will be there. Do you understand what I am saying? Vata dosh is disturbed and is attacking on the different tissues, and accordingly the different diseases will be formed. That is the importance that each and every dhatu we must study, and we should understand what are the properties, what is the composition of that particular dhatu, what are the functions, how the metabolism takes place, and what are the pathological situations, vruddhi and kshaya. Vruddhi is a excess and kshaya is a less. We will, with this, what you can say, the introduction and background, we will start actually the rasa dhatu. Try to understand. Rasa dhatu is basically liquid in nature. Is a nourishing fluid. Write down. Nourishing the fluid. Nourishing the fluid, liquid, for every part, for every cell, for every system, for every organ, it gives the nourishment. It can be compared with the different elements of our body. Rasa dhatu can be compared with plasma. Maximum people try to correlate rasa dhatu with the plasma. Personally, Dr. Deshpande say yes, it is correct. Rasa dhatu, because Ayurveda says rasa and rakta, rasa and rakta, plasma and blood cells, they together, this together we call it as a blood. So this blood is moving all over the body and giving different proteins to the muscles, then different calcium, phosphorus to the bones, vitamin D to the bones, Okay, so different nourishing factors, iron for the hemoglobin. These are the nutrients. Nutrients are supplied by the blood. Nutrients for the tissues are supplied by the blood. But Ayurveda says rasa and ratta together are moving. So rasa can be compared the plasma part of the blood, and ratta can be compared with the blood corpuscles, blood cells, RBC, red blood cell, WBC, white blood cell, lymphocytes. I think some part is very clear. Rasa dhatu can be compared with plasma, but not only plasma. Ayurveda has a concept udak dhatu. Write down udak. Udak is a water. Personally, I, Dr. Deshpande, believe that rasa dhatu has a relation with different watery elements. Different watery elements of our body. For example, cytoplasm is a water. Interstitial fluid, intracellular fluid, extracellular fluid. So all these fluids, even the lymph, any sort of synovial fluid, pleural fluid, okay, any fluid in the body, any watery part, any water and electrolyte mixture, all this is a part and parcel of rasa dhatu. Basically, rasa dhatu is a watery part. Don't forget it. Water. Water is most important for the rasa dhatu. Water is the most important. Not excess, not less. If water is less, our rasa dhatu becomes weak and we get a dehydration. Less water in the body because of the vomiting, because of the loose motion. Rasa dhatu becomes weak. Immunity becomes low. If more water is accumulated, then there is edema. Edema is also a problem with the rasa dhatu. So excess edema, rasa dhatu. Less dehydration connected with the rasa dhatu. So this is again some more introduction to the rasa dhatu. Now we'll start step by step how it is formed, where it is formed, what are the properties, what are the functions, etc. Let us start. So our primary digestion takes place from mouth to the small intestine. This is called as a primary digestion. Protein, carbohydrate, fats that we eat are converted to amino acids. Proteins, amino acids. Carbohydrate, glucose. Fats, fatty acids. So this conversion takes place in the mouth, in the stomach, in the duodenum, in the jejunum, in the ileum. And in the ileum, what is happening? That nutritious part, amino acids, glucose, are absorbed in the villi. Write down villi. VI, mucus folds are there. Blood vessels are there. They absorb. They absorb amino acid, fatty acids. Okay, so this is called as a sara part. Hear the word, Marathi medium, sara part, nutritious part. And then remaining part, waste part, is going to the large intestine. Pakvashaya in Ayurveda, large intestine, where only water is absorbed and fecal matter is created. Fecal matter is a waste part. So this is the Ayurvedic words are sara and kitta. Sara is a nutritious part. And kitta is a waste part. Okay, so this first fluid after primary digestion is called as, write down, ahara rasa, nutritious fluid, ahara rasa. Tatra panchabhautikasya chaturvidasya shadrasasya dvividavirasya ashtavidavirasya va aneka gunas upayuktasya aharasya samyak paranatasya yaha tejogutaha saraha Paramasukshmaha sa rasaha iti ucchate. Rasaha iti ucchate. It is said that this particular fluid as a rasa according to Sushrut Sutrasthan. Can you see my cursor? Sushrut Sutrasthan. Now, this is the description of ahar, that is food. These are the different classification. Panchabhautik food. Prithvi, aap, tej, vayu, akash. Chaturvidha. Bhaksha, peya, lehya. Some part can be eaten, some part can be drink. So there are four types of the taking the food. Shadrasasya. Madhura, amla, lavana, katutik, takashaya. Sweet, sour, salty. pungent, bitter, and astringent. These are the six tests in the food. Dvividha virya, some are hot, some are cooling. Ashtavidha viryasya, ruksha, snigdha, etc., etc. Va anek guna upayuktasya, aharasya samyak parinatasya. After proper transformation, after primary digestion, the fluid is generated. That fluid is paramasukshma. The molecules are very, very small. Nano molecules are there. And they can move all over the body and give the nutritions to the different dhatus. That part is called as a nutritious fluid or rasa dhatu in Ayurveda. Okay, let us move further. So here, absorption of sara and pitta. Here you can see, this is the intestinal wall. Okay, here you can see villi. Can you see these are the villi? See my cursor, please. Villi. Here, the blood vessels are there. Can you see the blood vessels? And nutrient absorption takes place in the ileum. Okay, rasa dhatu. Now, as each has a power to nourish all the dhatus, it is called as a tejobhuta. It is not hot. Why tejobhuta? Because of the power. What is power? To provide the nutritious material to all the dhatus. Then another word is a paramasukshma. Unless and until the particles are very small, they cannot move to the capillaries. That's why it is a paramasukshma. It can penetrate into the micro parts, micro channels of your body. Okay, next. Now, Sharandhara, he has more specified the concept of rasadhatu. He said how that particular nourishes fluid from the grahini, from the small intestine, that is carried to the heart through the liver. So he has mentioned grahini madhun rudayakadi, from small intestine to the heart. Jatra agnina vipatvaha sarabhutaha aharasaha grahinitaha. That aharasa, first word is aharasa. There is a little difference in aharasa and rasadhatu. Write down. Little difference. From small intestine up to the heart, that particular liquid is called as aharasa. And when it is oxygenated and it is moving from the heart throughout the body to the brain, to the toes, then that part is called as a blood, purified blood or plasma and blood cells. That is rasadhatu and raktadhatu. Okay. So how that particular aharasa from grahani to the rudaya is taken? Because of the help of samana marute raha, maruteha. Marut means vata. Samana vayu is a important type of the vata dosha. What is the role of samana vayu? Annam grahnati, pachati, vechayati and munchati. Take the nutritious part or the raw material, grahnati, pachati, metabolism is there, digestion is there, vivechayati, sarakitta vibhajan, nutrition and waste part, and annam grahnati, pachati, vivechayati, munchati. Waste part is thrown to the pakvashaya. Okay, next. Now, rasadhatu, sarudayat, from heart, chaturvimshanti dhamani, from the blood vessels, anupravish, it enters into the blood vessel and it is thrown urdhvagaha. Urdhva means upward part. Dasha, there are 10 vessels, important vessels. Dasha cha adhugaminya, 10 are taking the rasadhatu to the downward part. Chatastraha tiryaggaha, 4 will circulate in the transverse direction. Up direction, down direction and transverse direction. And what does it do? Kritsnam shairam. Kritsna means whole body. Sushruti is explaining these things. How the circulation, transportation of rasadhatu takes place. You understand? Transport of rasadhatu. Urdhva, other, up, down and transverse. Huh? What does it do? Tarpayati, vardhayati, dharayati and yapayati. These are the 4 important functions of rasadhatu. Please write down 4 important functions of rasadhatu explained by Sushruta. Tarpana. What is tarpana? Tarpana is a hydration of the body. Please write down hydration. Especially when hydration is mostly required by the brain. If we get the less water our brain get tired, we get the fatigue, we lose our concentration, we don't want to do anything. Huh? Oh, we're tired. Sunstroke in summer season. If we don't drink the water, tarpana is hampered. Tarpana is a hydration of the body. Vardayati, give the nourishment to the cells and gradual development of the cells. That is vardayati. Dharayati, to maintain the cellular structure, cellular function of each and every cell. Dharayati, to maintain. And yapayati, in the old age, to maintain the status quo. That means, you know, that in the old age, we cannot generate the new cells very fastly. In the old age, what is most important? We have to just maintain whatever quality, whatever quantity is there. We have to maintain till the death. So to maintain in the old age is called as a yapayati. There is a difference in vardayati and there is a difference in yapayati. So in the childhood, in the young age, more functions are vardayati, but in the old age it is only yapayati. Yapayati is specifically for the old age maintenance of the cells, cellular functions, cellular qualities. Okay, next. Here, same things are explained. Tarpayati, I have already explained you, it gives the instant hydration, water to each and every cell. So we get the energy. Utsaha, Chaitanya, Karya Shakti, and Tautamipana, freshness. In the summer season, when there is very too hot and we lose our water with a lot of sweat, we are so tired, and somebody gives you the fruit juice, sugar cane juice, it is rasadhatu. If you drink it, now I am fresh. Now that freshness is called as tarpayati. Vardayati, why the development is needed? Because natural feature of the sharir is shiryate tat shariram. So we have to replenish. There is always a degeneration. Catabolism and anabolism. Degeneration and regeneration. This is the cycle. Degeneration. Cycle. This cycle is maintained by rasadhatu. Dharayati, to maintain, especially the balance in between chaya and apachaya. Anabolism and catabolism should be balanced. Then that is called as metabolism. So dharayati is a proper physiological metabolism is maintained by rasadhatu. And yapayati, the degeneration in the old age is prevented by the function of yapayati. That is why the old people should take care that watery part in their body. They should drink enough water. Otherwise, they will have to admit in the hospital. Saline, IV fluids. So if you don't want it, always ask the old people to drink enough water, enough, as per the prakriti, and also drink a lot of fruit juices. Fresh fruit juices. I am not saying tanned fruit juices. Okay? Next. I think this is the function of ahara rasa. He says, tarpayati iti balam, madhyastha viran sarvan eva prinayati, vardhayati iti balam, dharayati iti sampurna dhatutvat, kechit dharayati iti atra jivayati iti pathanti, atrapi sa eva artha, yapayati iti vriddham, kshiyamana dehatva. Whatever the things I have explained already about tarpana, vardhanas, all that is given in the Sanskrit shloka, those who want, they can just take the snapshots, but I think I have explained all these things a lot in English. Okay. Here, ahara rasa. In the childhood period, as there is no metabolism, the ahara rasa is ready-made. That child is getting ready-made ahara rasa from the mother. This is explained by Sushruta Sharirasthan. Ahara rasa is ready-made available from the mother to the intrauterine fetus. I think that is the only nutshell of this shloka. I need not to go into the details. Okay. So, rasadhatu is responsible for tautavitapana. This is the Marathi word. Very fresh. And that freshness, inner hydration is reflected on your skin, reflected on your face. So, if your face is fresh, if your skin complexion is luster, very fresh quality of the skin, luster, pink color, then your rasadhatu, inner hydration is going on very properly. Okay. Prasanna kanti, prasanna mukha kamala, because otherwise it will be mlana. That means it is wrinkled. Your skin will be wrinkled. Dehydration, loss of elasticity will be there. Okay. Sushrut says how that rasa dhatu word has formed. Tatra rasa gatau dhatu ahraha gacchati ati ato rasaha ahraha. What is that meaning? Ahraha, 24 hours. The meaning of this ahraha is a 24 hours. So this watery circulation, blood circulation is taking place 24 hours by 7, by 365 days up to your end of your life. So rasa dhatu is working non-stop from birth to death. My dear friends, when you are understanding Ayurvedic terminology, the meaning is different at different context. Meaning of different word will be different in different references, in different context. For example, rasa word is used in rasa shastra subject of Ayurveda. We say rasaushadhi. For example, sutashekhar, bhratvat chintamani, arogya vardhini, rasa kalp, rasaushadhi. Here the word rasa is mercury. Herbo mineral products are called as a rasaushadhi. Okay, when I talk, I am eating the madhura rasa substances. That rasa word is for test, T-A-S-T-E, annachi chav. So when we talk about rasa dhatu, that concept is different. What I mean to say, there are different meaning at different references. Okay, so these are the synonyms, paryayi nave, that is synonyms. What are the different names for the rasa dhatu? First is the saumya dhatu. Rasa dhatu is very silent because it is carrying the nutrition. So whoever is giving the nutrition, that is always a very silent personality. It has having snigdha, unctuousness, shita, cooling effect, guru, that is nourishing effect. So because of these qualities, rasa dhatu is called as a saumya dhatu. Then ahara prasad, another name for the rasa dhatu, ahara prasad. Prasad is something that you get from the god. So after primary digestion, God is giving some nutritious fluid to me as a prasad. So that is called as a very useful part, ahara prasad. Dhatu sar, another name, paryay nav for the rasa dhatu is dhatu sar. Because essence, sarata means the quality. It is rasa dhatu is responsible for the quality of all the tissues. Rakta, mouse, med, asti, majja, shukra, all remaining six dhatus will be of best quality if your rasa dhatu is the best. This is very important. So much important to the rasa dhatu. Now, I have already explained different forms of rasa dhatu. For example, intracellular fluid is rasa dhatu. Interstitial fluid is rasa dhatu. Plasma, intravascular fluid is rasa dhatu. Extracellular fluid, ECF, is rasa dhatu. That is a part and parcel of the rasa dhatu. Okay? Different forms. I have explained you total body. Although we are looking like a solid person, my body has a nearly 60 to 70% of the fluids. All these fluids can be compared with the rasa dhatu of Ayurveda. Intracellular fluid, extracellular fluid. Extracellular fluid is again plasma and interstitial fluid. Interstitial fluid is made up of lymph and transcellular fluid, which have the cerebrospinal fluid, intraocular fluid, synovial fluid, pericardial fluid, pleural fluid, peritoneal fluid. All these elements can be compared or have a connection with rasa dhatu. When your rasa dhatu will damage, it will affect in all these body elements. So try to understand how it is very much important, rasa dhatu, in our body. Rasat, next, another name, rasatmak oj. Oj is immunity. Oj is immunity. So they are saying that rasa dhatu is responsible for body immunity. Okay. Then ahara tej agni sambhav. It is developed, it is generated after the samskar of agni. After the functioning of digestive juices of the food. Afterwards, it is developed. Ahara rasa and rasa dhatu. So they are agni sambhav. It is having some influence of the Agni on it. Okay, then Rakta cha poshanala javabdar, as it is responsible for formation of blood. Asruk kar, asruk means blood. It is responsible for giving the iron, zinc, copper to the formation of the RBCs. So Rasa dhatu is providing nutrition material to the Rakta dhatu, hemopoiesis. So Rasa dhatu is called as asruk kar. Okay. Then it is a mool dhatu and para dhatu. Para means shreshth, superior. So Rasa dhatu is a superior. Then it is also called as Atreya, because that particular rishi has invented or giving more information about Rasa dhatu. Okay. What is the sthan, specific part of the body? Tasya cha rudayam sthan. Basically it is originated from the rudaya, heart. Okay. Then chaturvimshanti dhamani, 24 vessels are there, and they spread all these Rasa dhatu throughout the body. So these blood vessels, whole body and heart are the sites, are the organs related with the Rasa dhatu. Okay. But here we have mentioned hrudaya shabdena atra, hrudaya shabdena atra, hrudaya upalakshitaha pradeshaha uchyate. That means they say it includes lungs, then the what you can say, the all the parts related with the around the heart in the chest region. So Rasa dhatu is basically not only actual the chambers of the heart, it is the chambers, it is connected with the circulation, but all other parts are also related with the Rasa dhatu. Okay. Then it is hrudaya means hrudaya samipa pradesh. Okay, so all the region around the heart. Okay. And then through the different macro and micro vessels, it is spread all over the body. Dhamani naam tatha khani rasau yair upachiyate. Kha means akash. So it is circulated through the minest arteries, arterioles, capillaries, venules, veins. So all these micro, macro, then cellular, what can the transport across cell membrane. So all these places are devoted to the Rasa dhatu. Okay. Rasabhanam sutasam hrudayam moolam tashicha dhamanyaha. This concept is very important. In Charaka Vimanasthan, Ayurveda has explained the very important concept of physiology, that is srotasa. What is exactly srotasa? Srotasa means micro and macro, small and macro channels. This is srotas. This is srotas. This is srotas. But my blood capillaries are having the lumen, that is also srotas. Cells are, cell membrane is having the pores, holes, that is also srotas. So there are, if we consider these small holes, which are according to Ayurveda, this is a space element, akash mahabhut, space, because it is hollow. So these hollowness will be innumerable, because cells are innumerable. So srotas number will be in, we cannot count the number of srotas. But still Ayurveda says 13 srotasas are important. Rasava srotas, raktava srotas, mamsava, each dhatu has its own srotas where the metabolic process takes place. Okay. And actually this particular srotas concept is very important, because when we talk about pathology, when we talk about treatment, Ayurveda says there is a stroto vaigunya or stroto dushti, and stroto vaigunya deformity and stroto dushti malfunctioning of the srotas is responsible for any disease. So for example, I talk about problems of the Rasa dhatu. Ayurveda says ama is a toxin, and that ama is get blocked in rasava srotas, and then fever is developed. So this is in short the pathogenesis of fever, pyrexia, bukhar. Okay, so this stroto vaigunya malfunctioning and stroto dushti. Stroto vaigunya is a structural type of the deformity, and stroto dushti is a functional type of the malfunctioning. Okay, so these moolasthana, each srotas has a moolasthana, and they are responsible for generation of that dhatu, or examination part of that dhatu, or controlling organ for that particular dhatu, that is called as a moola. Each srotas has moolasthana. Okay. This is the same thing we are talking about sthana, that Bhel has explained that this is a circular moment. Rudo raso nischalati tasmat eva cha sarvashah sirabhir hrudayam yati tasmat hrud prabhava sira. Krishna means sampurna, whole body is a site, is a place where the rasadhatu is functioning. Rasadhatu is not only functioning in the heart. Rasadhatu is functioning at the level of each and every cell of the body. Whole body is a functional area for the rasadhatu. And Bhel is one of the rishi, one of the scientists of Ayurveda. He has explained the cardiac cycle. He said that pure blood is thrown away and the impure blood is taken back. So this is explained in this shloka, cardiac cycle. Okay, next, sthan. When we want to check whether my rasadhatu is functioning well, then I have to do the clinical examination. So pulse examination is the most important part for checking the rasadhatu. As you know, my friends, whenever because of the lot of vomiting and lot of loose motions, the person gets dehydration. How we check? We check the pulse. If it is a feeble and 3D, very weak but fast, very weak and very fast, tachycardia but feeble, that is a sign of dehydration. So we can check that particular. Then we can check the blood pressure, because when your rasadhatu is less deficient, that called as a hypovolumic shock. Write down, hypo, less, volume, water volume, water and electrolyte balance is low. Hypo, shock. Shock is a less supply to the brain. Your brain is not getting proper nutrition, that is called as a shock. So when rasadhatu is less, it is causing hypovolumic shock. Immediately you have to give, at least at home, when the primary dehydration, first degree dehydration is there, you can give ORS, oral rehydration solution. Simple, what you can say, the lemon juice or lemon with water, with sugar, with salt. Okay. Then another rasavruddhi lakshana. I will discuss about rasavruddhi and rasakshaya afterwards, but you have to check these particular symptoms of rasavruddhi and rasakshaya. These are the pathological conditions. Remember. Okay. So we are talking about rasava sotas mulasthana. So these are the different arteries and veins that I have shown. These are related with the rasadhatu. Okay. Now sangatan, composition and structure. Ayurveda says each and every element on this earth is panchabhautik. Prithvi, aap, tej, vayu and akash. So every element is panchabhautik. Rasa, rakta, mouse, make. But rasadhatu has a predominance, of Jala Mahabhuta. So it is called as a apyorasa. Apya means water. Apyorasa, remember this word. And it is also Drava Anusari. It is watery element, fluid element. And it gives the snehana, anxiousness to the whole body, and jivana. It maintaining the life quality. That is called as a jivana. Jivana is a life. It maintaining the life quality. Okay. So as you can see, this is a soft. This is not very harsh type of the body element. So when you eat too much spicy things, too much chili things, what will happen? It is opposite to the properties of rasadhatu. What is happening? Because of that hot potency, spicy food, chili food, your rasadhatu becomes deficient, weak immunity, and naturally it will problem with your body. You will start angriness, irritation of your mind. Lot of things will happen because it will destroy the qualities of rasadhatu when you eat too much spicy food. Rasadhatu is always working under control of kapha dosha. Kapha dosha and rasadhatu are friends, very close friends. So whenever you go against with the kapha dosha, you know the kapha dosha properties. Snigdha, shito, gurur, mandha, shlakshna, sandra, mrudasthira. Anything, your lifestyle, your food is opposite to the kapha dosha, it will problematic to the rasadhatu also. It will problematic to the kapha dosha, it will problematic to the rasadhatu. Rasa and kapha are very much good friends of each other. Okay. Raso api shleshmavat. This is raso api shleshmavat. Shleshma means kapha dosha. Dhatu prakar. Each dhatu has the two important types. One is a poshak and another is a posh. Write down poshak, poshak. Here I have written these words. Poshak is a raw material. Poshak, nutritious material. Raw material, unstable dhatu, moving. But posha is a stable part. Posha is a final product. Poshak is a raw and posha is a final. When we are forming any furniture in our house, first the carpenter cuts the wood and then lot of dust is coming from that wood, okay, one part and another part, and then he joins everything. So after forming that stool, formation of stool is a final. But before that, the whatever he is doing is a poshak. Okay, so iron, copper, proteins are essential for the hemopoiesis. So all these materials, proteins, iron, zinc, copper, these are poshak raktadhatu. And when the blood cells are forming, they are poshak particular part. Okay, so poshak is a stable part. Next. Now parinamana. Parinamana is a metabolism. Please write down. Ayurveda has explained, each dhatu has its own metabolic process. Each dhatu has its own metabolic process. Metabolism is equal to parinamana, transformation. Tissue metabolism. Primary digestion is in the GI tract. And secondary digestion is at the tissue level. Rasa poshak ansh, that nutritious part, is coming in the rasa vasrotas. It is coming into that particular channel where there is a specific rasa agni. There is some enzymes. There are some fiery elements which are taking place in the metabolic process. They are participating in the metabolic process. And what will happen? Then sthayi posharas. Stable dhatu will be formed. Upadhatu, secondary tissues. This is another concept of Ayurveda. Secondary tissues, like each dhatu has a secondary tissues. Moreover, rasa dhatu has a secondary tissues, stanya and raja. So stanya means breast milk and raja is a menstrual bleeding per month in the females. So these two elements are connected with the rasa dhatu. If your rasa dhatu is good, stanya will be good. If your rasa dhatu is good, your menstrual discharge will be normal. Then also it is useful for the rakta poshakamsh. It is giving nourishment to the blood or to the next dhatu, rakta dhatu. And at the same time, during the metabolism, there is some waste part. Waste part is of two types. Sthula is a kapha and sukshma is a kleda. Kleda is a moisture. Very nano waste part in each tissue metabolic process, according to Ayurveda, is called as a kleda. Remember this word, okay? So parinaman, if the metabolism has to be taken place proper, what you need? It will need the nutritious material. What is that nutritious material? All the watery part in your food, beverages. So remember, if you day and night eating only raw, only raw, only raw, chatter patter, not substantial and having some liquid part in your food, that will affect your body. So during the food, Ayurveda says, if you compare imaginary four parts of your stomach, Ayurveda says two parts with the solid food, one part with the liquid part, and one part of your stomach for the air purpose, and one part should remain the blank. So this is the clear cut quantitatively measurement given by the Ayurveda. So what I mean to say, you need water as per your prakriti, as per your dhatu swarata, different juices, fruit juices, then curry, then takra, that is buttermilk, milk, especially the milk, remember. So this is important. But if you eat lot of time only dry food like toast and bread, varo, at any time you are doing lot of dieting and fasting, lot of fasting without taking care of your body, that will hamper your rasa dhatu and it will suffer the different diseases. Okay. Then your diet should have the unctuousness. There should be a typical ghee. Ghee is very important as a snigdha. Because if you eat the lot of fried food, that can hamper your digestion process. Then there are different theories how that particular digestion process occurs or metabolism occur. Here you can see the words khale kapota nyay and kshira dadhi nyay and kedar kulya nyay. I will discuss about all these theories of metabolism after some time or in another lecture. Parinamana kaal, how much time it will take to form the rasadhatu? Ayurveda says minimum 1 day is required to form the stable rasadhatu. Okay. Next, what are the properties of rasadhatu? Dravata, fluid, liquid is the most important part. If it is a solid, if it is a dry, your body is dry, that can cause the diseases. Then it has all the properties very similar to the kapha dosha. Raso api shtesh mavat. So it is snigdha like the ghee and oil. Okay. So these are the examples. You must drink enough water, the milk, then the tea and coffee. But tea and coffee are not that much favorable for rasadhatu. Limited amount, it's okay. Milk is the best. Milk is the best. Fruit juices are the best. Then medicated water is the best. Okay. Sheet. So, because tea and coffee are after all giving your body more heat, so that is not expected in the rasadhatu. Guru, it has some nutritious properties. Okay, shlakshna and pichila. So their food some have the unctuousness in your foodstuff because that will make a union of the different molecules. Okay, then it has been described that the varna or the color of the rasadhatu is the shweta. If you understand the process of erythropoiesis, that has, even you open the book of modern physiology and try to read the erythropoiesis, they say from the basic liquid part, the color changes are there. And finally, red color comes to the blood. It is not directly blood is red. There are different stages of the color changing. And Ayurveda has explained also those color change from rasadhatu to raktadhatu, shweta, kapota, haridra, padmaka, kinshuka, alakta. These are the different color changes explained by one tikakar or the critics of Harita or the Shivadas. These are the names of the person. They have written the critics on Sushruta Sutrasthan and they have given this explanation that when rasadhatu is converted to the raktadhatu, color is changing from white to the red, shweta to the alakta. Alakta means red color. Here you can see. Okay. Next, we will go further. Praman. Ayurveda says how much is the quantity of whole body fluid. So Ayurveda, according to Ayurvedic opinion, it is a Nava Anjalaya. Nava, here you can see Nava Anjalaya. Whenever the liquid material is there, Ayurveda using, you can see this Anjala is Onjali, hand spoonful. Hand spoonful is according to Ayurveda Anjali Praman. But I'm sorry to say this part is under research process. Still, it is not very well confirmed or very, very clear by the even Ayurvedic scientists how that particular Nav Anjali, 1, 2, 3, 4, how that 9 hand spoonful rasadhatu can be measurable at the practical level. How in the laboratory we can do, it is not yet very clear. There are differences of opinions. I will not go into that factor. But what I mean to say, the people who say that Ayurveda is vague, Ayurveda is only qualitative, Ayurveda don't have any measurements. Here I would like to tell them that see these particular references. And we all can do the research on that. But Ayurveda science has mentioned the exact measurement of different body elements. So rasadhatu is explained as a 9 anjali, hand spoonful of material is there. But Sushruti is very clear. Sushruti is a super. He says it is very difficult to tell at exactly given time how much is the rasadhatu in your body, how much is the raktadhatu in your body. So he says, dosha dhatu malanam tu parimanam na vidyate. You cannot tell exact measurement. Why Sushruti is saying like that? Because it has some logic. He says that degeneration, regeneration, degeneration, regeneration is a continuous process. Every cell is dying and new cell is coming. Every cell is dying, new cell is coming. So how we can measure at a particular time? That's why he says, dosha dhatu malanam parimanam tu na vidyate. Okay. Next, dhatu karya. What is the functions of rasadhatu? The first function is very common to all the dhatus, that is dhru dharyati, to maintain our body physiology, body anatomy, from birth to death is a rule of all the dhatus. Dhatus are like matter, and vata, pitta, kapha are like energy. So our human body has a control of energy, matter, matter and energy. Energy is working through the medium of matter. Doshas are working through the medium of dhatu. Now next, Vagbhat, Ashtanga Rudra, he has given the Shrestha, the best function of each dhatu. Best function of each dhatu. What is that shloka? You must remember by heart. Prenanam jivanam lepaha sneho dharana purane garbhotpadash dhatu nam shrestham karma kramatam. So all the seven. One, prenan is the best function of rasadhatu. Jivana, best function of raktadhatu. Lepana, covering, protection, is the best function of mouse dhatu. Sneho, given unctuousness, is the best function of medh dhatu, fat tissue. Dharana, to hold your body upright, is the most important function of asti dhatu. Purana, filling the space in between or connection with the different tissues, neuromuscular junction. So purana, inside the bones, inside the cranium, that is majja dhatu. And garbhotpadana, reproduction, is the most useful or the best function of shukra dhatu. So in this shloka, Vagbhat has given the number one, number first, best function of each dhatu. Prenanam jivanam lepana. Prenan is a hydration. As I am repeatedly telling you, prenan is the best function of rasa dhatu, to giving water and electrolyte balance to each and every cell of the body, to each and every organ, to each and every system. Rasa dhatu is responsible for water and electrolyte balance. Rasa dhatu is responsible for water and electrolyte balance, giving instant energy by providing watery elements. Prenana, instant. Prenana word is giving is bruhana, is not instant. Mausa dhatu is responsible for bruhana, increasing your weight, increasing your body mass, increasing your muscle tissue. That is not an instant process, that is step by step. But prenana is always instant. When you are tired, when you get the sun stroke, and if we give him saline, immediately it becomes fresh. So that instant freshness is called as a prenan. Instant freshness is called as a prenan. Don't forget that. Okay. Prenan is appyayana. I have already explained about importance of oral rehydration therapy or IV and saline. These are the part and parcel of rasa dhatu. If rasa dhatu deficient is there, water loss is there, dehydration is there, we have to use this oral rehydration solutions. Okay, next we will go further. Here you can see rasa function prenana. In the summer, because of not getting enough water, the leaves are like this. Can you see? Leaves are like this, drop down. But when we provide water, zoom, zoom. No water, drop down. Energy drop down. Here you can see, drop down. Leaves are dropped down. But here, after getting the water, zoom, freshness, prenana. So I have explained in a very nice way, pictorial. Share this. Share this video to all your friends. Can you see prenana? Can you see? All these are giving you the freshness. And that freshness is looking on the face. So this is, her rasa dhatu is definitely good. Her rasa dhatu is definitely good. Okay. So prenana tarpana. Another word is tarpana. So tarpana is basically mental related or brain related, mind related. When your mind is fresh because of the proper hydration, fruit juice, sugarcane juice, milk, water, then that is called as a tarpana. Prenana and tarpana. Prenana is a physical level. Tarpana is a mental level. Prenana is body cells. Tarpana is for mind cells, brain cells. Can you differentiate? Physical hydration, brain hydration, psychological freshness. All these are important. Okay. Tushti. Tushti is again related with psychological. After eating, after drinking water, I get tarpan. I am becoming energetic. I am becoming fresh. My weight has not been increased instantly, but that is instant freshness. your mind and body, that is tarpan. Okay, dharan, yes, as rasadhatu is giving the nutrition to all the rakta mounds made asthi majja, that is maintaining our body, that is maintaining our body. Yapana, I already explained, vruddha yapayati kshinamana dehatva. When everything has been lost, no regeneration is possible, no growth is possible. What the nature is doing? Nature is doing after 50 or 60, just maintaining. It is not giving any new things to you. It is maintaining. That is yapana in Ayurveda. Yapana in Ayurveda. Okay? So old people should take care of water. I am always telling you, my dear friends, in the very small children and in the very old age, vomiting and loose motion should be taken very seriously, because problem of dehydration is very common in the old people and the children. Okay. Then there are another functions that I have mentioned. I think prenan function that I have discussed. So what Vasudhatu is doing? Facts about the water. Facts about the water. This is 83% then moistens the oxygen for breathing, helps convert the different functions of the water. These are all functions of Vasudhatu, my dear friends. Remember, that helps to convert the food for digestion. Water is required. Kledak kapha is there. Bodhak kapha is there. They are representing the rasadhatu, okay? That removes the waste part. If your water is less, you will suffer from constipation. That is again the problem of rasadhatu. Water, udaka, rasadhatu, all are similar. So constipation will be there. Then cushions for your joints. Your synovial fluid will be less. If you drink the less water, don't drink the milk, your joints will start cracking. Because there is no water. Rasadhatu is there in your joints. Okay. Then if your rasadhatu is bad, of poor quality, you will have the less hemoglobin. You will suffer from weight loss. You will suffer from the bony joint pain. You will suffer from the different problems like Alzheimer's disease, Parkinsonism, multiple motor neuron disease, myasthenia gravis. All these diseases are possible indirectly. I am saying indirectly because of the deficiency of rasadhatu. Even you will suffer from infertility. You will shock. Sir, how it is? Water? That spermatozoa? That ovum? What is the relation? It has some relation. Don't forget. Sometime I will explain all these things in detail. But now we are just studying. So I am saying that rasadhatu is connected to each and every tissue, and each and every tissue quality will be maintained if your rasadhatu is good. But rasadhatu is depend on primary digestion, on ahar rasa. Here comes the Ayurveda. Here comes the Ayurveda. Rogaha sarve api mandegnau. Write down this word. Ayurveda says rogaha diseases sarve api, from cold to cancer, from cold to corona, all the diseases are because of the faulty digestion. Your digestion is not proper. Your appetite is not good. Your stools are not good. Your urine is not good. So these primary digestion, it is not getting proper ahara nutritious fluid. So rasadhatu is not proper. So body elements, they will not get the proper nourishment. Your immunity will be low and you will suffer from any disease. This is the logical chain. You must understand this basic chain, and you write down these chains or explain to the patient how that rasadhatu is important. Okay. Compare the ahara rasa and rasadhatu. Ahara rasa is the most first part of your digestion. So the functions are innumerable. The rasa functions are little bit compared to the ahara rasa limited. Ahara rasa is moving all throughout the body. Rasadhatu is concerned with the srotas, specific organs. Ahara rasa is unstable, rasadhatu is the stable part. Ahara rasa is being tarpana, vardhana, dharana, yapana. Rasa is predominantly doing the prenana and tarpana. Okay, then what is the difference in tarpana and bruhana? Tarpana is basically related with the hydration, and bruhana is related with some proteins and carbohydrates. In the long run, parthiva and apya dravya are essential. Tarpana is instant energy, and bruhana is the growth after typical period. Tarpana is related with the drava and sheetha property, liquid and cooling property. Bruhana is depend on drava, Shita, Snigdha, and Guru also. Guru. Guru is necessary for Guruan. Guru is not necessary for Tarpan. Okay. Here Siddha Jala is like Tarpana, medicated water. Here wheat, black gram, and the dates are doing the Guruan. Here wet increase is not considered with the Tarpan. In Gruhana, wet increase is expected. Here instant energy, and here you get the nourishment because of the fertilizers, because of the water, because of the sunlight. So development of the tree, that is I am talking about. Okay. Now this is the Dhatu Sarata, is the quality examination. Ayurveda says that there is a very easy way to test the dehydration, the quality of Rasa Dhatu. They say that this Sarata is a qualitative assessment. It is responsible for the oj or immunity, and Rasa Sarata is equal to Tvaka Sarata. Rasa Sarata is equal to Tvaka Sarata. You just examine your skin, skin texture, skin complexion, and also see the, that is body hair, not the scalp hair, body hair. Loma. Here you can see Snigdha, Shlakshna, Mrudu, Prasanna, Sukshma, Alpa Gambira, Sukumara Loma, Saprabhevacha Tvaksarana. Your skin is Snigdha Anchas, smooth Shlakshna, soft, Prasanna, very fresh. Then this Loma, Loma Sukshma, very small. This hair should not be very big. Alpa, the quantity should be less of this body hair. And then Saprabha, great complexion. Because of this Sarata, because of this good quality of Rasa Dhatu, the person will be lucky person, because his health will be normal, health will be for a long run, fitness will be there. Aishwarya, he will get lot of money. Why? Because Arogyam Dhana Sampada, health is wealth. Because of the health, he can work very nicely in his office, in his business, and then he get the money. He can enjoy that money because health is there. Buddhi, his brain is functioning very well. So intelligence will be good. Vidya, his knowledge will be good. Arogya, health will be good. Long life. Praharshana, very always fresh and energetic. Aishatvam chachashti. These are the benefits in the second life. Okay. Next. So these are the body hairs that I have described. So these are the again composition of this is Rasa Dhatu good. This is a little bit problematic. Rasa Dhatu, a lot of hair. So these are the different tests. You can ask the person whether if you get the food in a proper time, whether you can maintain your stamina or you lose your stamina. If he losing his stamina immediately, that Rasa Dhatu may be weak. Okay. Then you can ask if they have any history of vomiting and dehydration. If at all it is there, then whether the patient is required to admit in the hospital immediately and give the saline, then naturally his Rasa Dhatu may be weak. But one second pause, and I am explaining you very important statement. Prakruti is not changeable. Prakruti, biotype, constitution is permanent. Vata prakruti, pitta prakruti, kapha prakruti. Vata pitta prakruti, vata kapha prakruti, pitta kapha prakruti. Prakruti is permanent, stable, not changing from birth to death. Birth to death, not changing. Not changing. Prakruti is an examination of dosha. Sarata is an examination of dhatu. Sarata is an examination of dhatu. Sarata can be changed. Sarata can be changed as per your food, as per lifestyle, as per disease. For example, I have normally very good rasa dhatu, but by chance I got the contaminated water drinking, and I start gastroenteritis, vomiting, lose motion, vomiting, lose motion. And then my rasa dhatu sarata becomes low. But when I get again cured for that infection, cured from that infection, I get enough ORS, oral rehydration, I get the saline, and within 3-4 days, my rasa dhatu becomes very good again. So rasa dhatu can be deficient, rasa dhatu can be normal, rasa dhatu can be excess. These are the three stages. You must remember, rasa dhatu sarata cannot be a permanent. It can be normally it is, on an average it is permanent, homeostasis. But sometimes it can up and down according to the disease. Okay. Next. And you can ask about the or observe darshana sparshana pratna inspection. You can see by your eyes how is his skin, how is your loma or the body hair, and you can decide the sarata. Okay. Now, if your rasa is not proper of good quality, what can be the symptoms? This is most important part of this video. If your rasa dhatu is not good, you will suffer from anorexia. You will lose your appetite because digestion will not be proper. Anna pachan vyavasthit na hone, indigestion will be there. Tondala chav nasne, you will lost the proper taste sensation. Murmur, nausea will be there. Your body will be always feeling like heavy because of ama toxins. Then you will always feel sleepy. Then you will get mild feverish sensation, anemia, and khalitya and palitya, baldness, as well as early premature graying and premature baldness can occur because of the improper rasa dhatu. Here you can see rasa sarata on this side and rasa asarata on this side. Okay, what tonics, what medicines you can take? Number one, shatavari kalpa with the milk to maintain your rasa dhatu. Laghu malini vasant, kharjura manth, dates from the dates water, lacha popcorn, tarpana phalaras fruit juices, arogya vardhini if there is amata, ama is their toxin, gulvena sattva and amrutarishta. These are the rasayan or the tonics for the rasa dhatu. Okay, upadhatu we will discuss at some another time about the secondary tissues of upadhatu, that is tanya and raja. Similarly with the mala, that is kapha is a mala, how that can be explained, that we will discuss in another session. Now about the pathology. Pathology is vruddhi and kshaya, vikruti, rasa vruddhi and rasa kshaya. This vruddhi hyper pathological and low is happening three ways: dravyataha, gunataha and karmataha, by substance, by properties and by functions. This can happen. Kshaya also by substance, by properties and by functions. Okay, the most important principle behind this is the samanya vishesha siddhanta, principle of homologous and heterologous. Samanya vishesha siddhanta. Okay, if I take heavy undigested a lot of bad food, then what will happen? There will be indigestion and ama will be created, and that ama dosha will hamper my quality of rasa dhatu. That ama will block my channels, and then what I should get the treatment? I should do the fasting. Fasting is the best treatment for the rasa vruddhi. Okay, what it does because of the indigestion and rasa vruddhi? Pathological increase, raso api shleshmavat. So all the problems like the kapha vruddhi, for example, there will be indigestion, nausea will be there. Okay, praseka means excessive watering to the mouth. Tylism, it is called as a tylism, p-t-y-a-l-i-s-m. So tylism, all these symptoms indicate indigestion. Primary digestion is not proper, ama is developed, ama is a toxin, that toxin is mixed with the rasa dhatu, and quality and function of the rasa dhatu is damaged. Rasa dhatu is problematic. Rasa vruddhi, can you see? She has a pain in abdomen and starting vomiting. Rasa vruddhi, she must do little bit fasting. Okay, rasa vruddhi, can you see? Ruddha kled, here also the patient gets uncomfort in the chest. Can you see? Prasek, can you see this child with a lot of saliva? This is called as a prasek, saliva. Pictures are very good, pictures are very good. Then so we can give the rasa vruddhi, we have to treat the agnimandya, ajirna and amanirmiti. So we must do the fasting, light diet or bitter herbs. Like for example, guduchi, kutaki and kadechirai. Guduchi, kutaki and kadechirai, single herbal tablets. Also to reduce the, if there is edema, then you can use the punarnava, single herbal tablets. Okay. So these are no food, fasting for rasa vruddhi. Causes of rasa kshaya. If you are having the marathon and lot of exercises in the grishma rutu or the hot season, that can cause the rasa kshaya, deficiency of water, dehydration. If you have a lot of vomiting and a lot of loose motion, can you see? Very interesting picture, easy to remember. Vomiting, here, loose motions. Gastroenteritis, dehydration will be there. Okay. रसे रोक्षम क्षमा शोषो ग्लानि शब्दाशिष्णुता रस क्षये हृत पीड़ा कंप शून्यता कृष्णा च एक्सप्लेन बाय वाग्भट वाग्भट इज सेइंग व्हाट आर द सिम्टम्स ऑफ डिहाइड्रेशन फर्स्ट इज अ ड्राइनेस मीन्स लॉस ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ द स्किन इफ यू पिंच ओवर हियर एंड यू रिलीज normally it should be in a normal but that pinch wrinkle remains the same as it is for 5 minutes then it is called as rukshata dryness of the skin shrama tiredness shosha dryness on the lips and palate and you become thirsty okay shosha means dryness in the mouth and the person feels thirsty this is the child he always move the lip tongue like this to make the wetness in the lips okay then glani unconsciousness drowsiness shabd asishnuta he don't want to hear any sound he becomes restless irritable angry stop that mobile that is because of rasakshaya ruta pida palpitation kampa hrutkampa tremors shunyata whole emptiness in the body and trishna what is that polydipsia write down polydipsia excessive thirst okay this is all dehydration so this is all thing that I have explained over here but now we will go for the here you can see wrinkle how to check the dehydration best photographs in the ppt then here you can see soft spot this is the flat over there then too sleepy then this is the person is crying wet diapers all these are the you can check the dehydration status what you can do lajamand medicated water kharjuramanth lemon juice sarbat iv fluids and normal saline here you can see the oral rehydration solution this is very good for rasakshaya or even the saline the 6 level teaspoon of sugar then salt and then 1 liter of water boil it pull it down and give sip by sip continuously in the rasakshaya here also for the rasakshaya fruit juices are there not ready made don't drink the milk juice I'm not telling the mixing of milkshake is not good milkshake is viruddha anna milkshake is incompatible food I'm not expecting that I'm not expecting synthetic ready-made homemade juices are in ORS here you can see the ready-made packs are there so finally it has been said by different ayurvedic people that rasa dhatu is very good for our body and is very essential element of our body so rasajam purusham vidya rasam rakshet prayatnatah I should make a lot of efforts to maintain the quality and quantity of my rasa dhatu I think this is the end of our rasa dhatu topic which is the first dhatu in our 7 tissues and I hope you have liked this particular discussion so I am very thankful for your patience hearing and I wish all the best please share this my videos like this give me the feedback mail me do whatsapp me with your writing your name college name then the year etc and subscribe my youtube channel not only you but you become a health ambassador and you circulate all these videos to your colleagues friends from first year to the last year and then request on behalf of me please subscribe youtube channel of Dr. Deshpande because he is doing a lot of effort to teach to share his knowledge and experience with the bms students teachers and doctors and also for the common man so Dr. Deshpande's videos are for everybody in different languages so thank you once again I am now doing the stopping of this video okay so here we will go back again and I will try to control my this I can take it up okay and then here I can stop my sharing okay then here my friends bye bye I'm seeing you bye bye take care